Hey there! Welcome to Life, Noggin. You humans are strange and complex creatures. You've got all these organs and tissues working together in just the right way for you to function. Not all life is like this. In fact, the first life forms on Earth consisted of just single cells, all on their lonesome. We're still learning how these simple species became complex beings, and eventually you. It's clear it didn't happen all at once. The main theory is that multicellular organisms started out as cells grouped together in colonies. Some scientists count these as the first complex life forms. But many think that for it to truly be multicellular life, the cells have to be connected, communicating, and cooperating with each other. Depending on how you view it, there were between 13 and 25 branches of complex organisms that evolved into different types of animals, plants, fungi, algae, and bacteria. Each lineage evolved in its own way, but most ended up with similar types of cell structures. So if we know the different branches, why can't we just trace them back to see how they started? Well, it's not quite that easy to find fossils, and the ones we do find aren't always very clear. But recently, scientists discovered what is probably the oldest evidence of multicellular life that isn't just cell colonies. Buried 2,600 feet under South Africa, they found a possible fossilized fungus that is 2.4 billion years old. And complex life might have existed even before that. The chances of any organism being fossilized are pretty low, which means some pieces of the story are likely missing. Besides fossils, scientists look for evidence of the conditions needed to support life. This is similar to how they look for life in space. They might not find aliens, but they can locate water, which is necessary for all life that we know of. If liquid water exists on a planet, it's possible life survived there as well. On Earth, they study rocks to look for evidence of oxygen in the atmosphere billions of years ago. Even with this evidence, it's hard to know when complex life really started. And to make it even more difficult, scientists think that some species went from single cells to multicellular colonies and back, based on the conditions. So what made the transition stick? As life evolved, there may have been advantages for certain cells that stayed together. These so-called ratcheting mechanisms likely prevented the cells from reverting back to their old solitary ways. For example, as cells evolved to do different tasks, they could have relied on each other for support. One cell might have made a necessary compound while another created an important molecule. This meant they were stronger together than apart. We obviously need a lot more research to understand how and when life became multicellular. But one thing is clear, humans are just one species in a long line of intricate and complex beings. And in my opinion, you're also the coolest. So what is your favorite form of complex life? People? Cats? That 2 billion year old fungus? Let me know in the comments section below. And if you enjoyed this video, then you're definitely gonna wanna check out our video on how important the first years of your life really are. The power of recognition also dramatically shoots up, tied to significant growth occurring in the hippocampus. Every time I say hippocampus, I always think about a bunch of hippos going to college, and it makes me smile. As always, my name is Blacko, this has been Life Noggin, don't forget to keep on thinking.